name is Stoyan, and today I will talk about the multi-rotors. And so I'm not sure if you can imagine what's the talk about. Maybe you think about this one, Obama drones, like something. And there's another news, the Japanese Seikon will start using these ones. You can, in fact, like rent them. So we'll have Skynet soon. And the other interesting, it's pretty interesting. If you see DroneNet is the next big thing. If you think, now we connect a lot of sensors to internet, so we can measure stuff, but we cannot physically move stuff. For example, if I forgot my Keitai here and I want to have it home, if I have my own drone, I can send it here and it will bring it home. So maybe someday we'll have this one. No, they have return to home possibility.
But I mean, if you leave your cell phone at home, how do you tell the drone to bring it home?
No, the drone is home. And my Keitai is here. So I send the drone from home to here to get the...
to bring your cell phone home?
Yes. Yeah. Yes.
This but then you can't use your drone after that. And why would you do that?
Well, your bento box.
No, you need two cell phones.
The box one is good. After this, you have your bento on.
It's not. I will not try to teach you and to how to see lesson you. It's just more like a diary. What happens with me? How I fell down from programmer to Arduino hardware guy and now playing with toys.
Yeah, couple months ago you were an Arduino guy.
Yes, now I'm falling down, man. every day I'm like this one.
I hope they will not deploy you to Iraq or something.
Yeah. So yes, it's starting with this guy. If you remember, I was talking about Arduino, and this one is Arduino, very small one, mini. It's not so hot, see, rare stuff, everybody using it, it's just small. So in projects, like, I don't know, it's like Nissan or something, even less. And I was searching for different sensors, so I go through the LED blinking and stuff. So I was thinking, okay, something interesting, and I found this guy, which you can see is like three-axis gyro and accelerometer meter, which means it can track how it's positioning in the space, how many degrees in every axis, and how it's moving. So if I change something in it, it will track everything. this small guy. So I was thinking,
yours for $299.
It's good technology just in this one. You can see the price is pretty affordable. We can have like big power in small parts. So I think, fuck, three axes, this means like, fine. Man, because let's see, two axes, I made some robots, but three axes means flying, man. So I was like, yeah, wow. And so, everybody's thinking about this. I think you can, let's see, afford this with powerful drugs, but maybe this, some other, man. So I will try to show you what hooked me up very much. So I just found this guy. This one, it's beautiful. Just a second. This also. Okay, make this bigger.
Double click it in the middle.
You click on the green button
at the bottom right.
Upper left. Yeah. Oh. Yes.
So see, it's beautiful. You don't need many drugs for this. You just need the special equipment. So I researched a lot how they make this stuff.
Oh, it's a video from a drone.
Yes, it's a video from some guy. Who is... okay.
It's not CGI.
No, it's not CGI. It's real picture. There was some Skyrim moves or something there.
Skynet.
So see, you want to do this? Like, sorry. Wow.
Don't follow you while you're snowboarding.
Fuck yeah,
Google Glass, man.
It's same technology. Yeah.
What do I need a drone if it's on my glasses?
You can have a huge glasses like this one, and some like transmitter there.
Ski technology.
So yes.
So how do you get this range? Like this guy is like somewhere else. What do I need to? How far is this guy from there?
Because you can be on kilometers in general now.
I mean,
many kilometers.
Oh, 2-3
kilometers. Oh, yes. You just need money. Let's tell you, you need money because everything is very expensive. Like this one, the camera is GoPro. Maybe you know it. It's like action camera. It costs like Nima. But you need something to lift this camera. Mm. So it can be everything. You can throw it from some far things, but it's one way. If you want some control, you put it on something to lift it and go with this one. And one of the good lifting things was this quadcopters. Mm. So I researched it more because I want to do this. And I found this guy. Mm-hmm. It's famous. Mm. Like, let's see. You search quadcopter, it's first guy in the Google search. And it's even in Apple Store. You can buy Apple Store. So bad, but see the price, it's some money. So let's stop dreaming. So yes, I was obsessed with the drone guy. I wanted to buy one, but after thinking,
your wife said,
I didn't even tell her. So let's go see. It's about product against like platform. So this drone is extremely cool product. I want it, but Hatsi, I'm sure next day I will broke it. Over. My cool product is fuck. So I don't want product. I need platform. Means it needs to be cheap, and I want it now. Also, yes. So no, you can have it in Apple Store, but it's not cheap. So you need parts, and with this guy. The parts are sold only by this company, so it's not very affordable. Also, I want to make changes, something. I need to fix like color, it may be maybe easy, but some stuff. But this one is like pocket. It's cool, but you cannot change it. Another one, skeleton means how to see. In the world, the only one drone with, it's how to see. You can manage this drone with iPad, but there's no other drones that you can manage with iPad, only this one. So you cannot switch to another drone or something. You are bound to this guy. You don't scale. It's just poof, this one. And also about the community, it's pretty new, so there's not many people. Do somebody to try it, have tried this one?
Yeah, and it's only indoor because it's whenever there's wind, it goes away.
It's huge. It's like this one.
But even it's indoor only.
So it was not very good for me. So I need to make some changes in my dreams. And the things that we saw is called like first person view. Means you are looking through this camera. You put like cool glasses here, and when you control it, you can see where it's going. But it's not for me still. So other one is acrobatic. You make smaller things and you can show them. You don't have usually camera. It's like this one. So you just bam, So, and before telling it about the cool stuff, let's take a little bit of theory about the aerodynamics. And now the very, how to see, complicated picture from NASA. But in fact, it's very simple. If you someday try to, I'm not sure in Japan, in Bulgaria, we can open the windows on the train. And if you just put your hand like this one, it's lifting you up. Like this one, this is the lift. So if you have something coming here to the wing, it's lifting you up. So it's the lifting power. I can show you. So you just put it like this one, and it will lift you up. This is this important lift power. So you just need to blow it from here, like, and to lift it. This is the meaning of this very complicated picture. But usually when we rotate something, not only moving it like this, when you rotate something, there's one more very important force named, I'm not sure about my English, how is this, torque. Momentum. Means, how to see, if you rotate this thing, the whole body below will start to rotate. Maybe you try it in the museum, they have like cool toy. You rotate one small wheel here, and your sitting stool start rotating like this one. This is the torque. It's just coming from here and rotating the thing below. And very easy explanation.
By the way, this is angular momentum. It's not momentum, it's angular momentum.
Okay, angular momentum. So, and these explanations in the action movie when they cut the propeller on the back, the helicopter starts spinning like this and over. And how you can prevent this? We can prevent this by small propeller here. Or you can put two propellers which are spinning in the opposite directions.
Which is what you have right there, right?
Yes, and that's why I wanted to show this guy. It's the helicopter. It's what is the difference from what I checked? The helicopters by in Wikipedia invented by Leonardo da Vinci. It's just single rotor. So you can put here the 10 propellers, but they will be just one motor. Here. So they're like one rotor, single rotor. And it maybe will fly again. I'm not sure. No. We don't have batteries anymore. It's maybe still need some pounding time. But you can see the propellers are, I'm not sure if you can see, but in the moment I can just move it up and down. Other things are just arrows. And if you want to move it somewhere, I can change the speed of the two propellers so it will rotate. But if I want to move it somewhere, I need to use the small guy on the back. So see, it's moving only when I trying to move it somewhere.
Okay, goes here.
Like this one. So this is the helicopters, but Hotsi, this is not very precise description because Hotsi, this one seems also to be helicopter. It's not single rotor, but I'm not sure. But still, this is the helicopter. So today we will talk about the more than two motors. Which is the multicopter. So they have different configurations. Usually the smallest is three rotors. So these two big guys, they're spinning the opposite direction. So they're just lifting you. And there's like a third propeller plus a servo which is like moving in different directions. So you can like drift and stuff like this. And the cool for the photograph for the this aerophotography or something. So there is nothing in front of it. So we have very clean view. There's no propeller spinning in front of you. So it's very affordable platform for the actions that I show you there. Pretty good. I'm just let's see. The third propeller is a little difficult to do this servo stuff. Means like some magic you need to do this. But it's good. I want to try it someday. One bad news about this one is there is no redundancy. One of your propellers is over and you are down. So I'm flying now quadcopters, which have four guys. More propellers means more lifting power. Because with these helicopters, even if you have two propellers, they're just like, they don't have enough power to lift things. And it's very difficult to move them. You need to rotate all the things to go there. But this guy, they can fly everywhere. So they're very, very good. And still, it's no redundancy. One propeller down and you are down. So, more. Hexacopters. And this guy, it has redundancy. Even one or two of these helicopters are down, you're still okay. So. Yes, true. But the professionals using mostly this one. For example, this disaster first, how to see, the people who go first, they can use them. The volcanoes, I saw some they using it. So, and I think the second we were using these ones. So, and we have more.
Wow.
Octocopters. So, how to see, you know. It's madness! Sparta! So, let's see. I know only about the octocopters. I know they also start putting one more propeller on bottom. So it's like two. So
how much is this?
It will become 16, but I don't know how to see this in Greece maybe.
Octocopter?
I mean, how much?
16.
Like the price, how much is this one? Like?
Yes. The other problem is every rotor, for example, the cheap one will cost you like Nissenen, for example, per rotor. Means 8 of them will be pretty much, only for motors. This is the cheap one, the more expensive and more money. I know. I'm not on this still. So let's talk more about the common stuff, not about the differences.
Roughly it's 3,000 euro for that.
Bravo.
Mm. 3,000 euros.
Well, not bad. You can pay it off with the videos and all that. Like.
But for the toy, it's pretty.
No, like rent it or like rent yourself. Like you have a wedding or something. Have a wedding with.
If I have something to do, for example, if I have a huge Bokujo with thousands of toes, I will tomorrow buy one.
Make movies and stuff.
Yes, but to find it.
This is a game.
Really?
To flying it home?
Not in Japan.
So, okay, the parts. We have the propellers. So, if you see, they will rotate in different directions. That's why they're not the same. They're like clockwise and counterclockwise. So, you need this for multi-rotors. You need to have both types. Just one will not do because it will rotate like this one. So, if you rotate like this one, it will stay. Okay, propellers. Next one is LiPo. LiPo guys. You need to be extremely, extremely careful with the LiPo guys because they explode. Yes, no. Always put them in some safe place.
It's not safe enough. You should really have.
Yes, because obviously the temperature is 1,000 degrees.
Yeah, you should really buy.
But my small, so even if it explodes, so never overcharge them.
There are some cars that's been completely burned because of small batteries like that. So
yes, be careful. Life will.
So if I shoot that right, that's how to fire bag.
Yes. Yeah,
I have one bomb. Special bag. Life will guard.
Not this one. What's
the just for now.
A metal container would shoot better easier.
That's
right. Shoebox.
So, yeah. Yes, recently they start using nickel something something, but it's too heavy for the helicopter. For cars, if you have Rajikon cars, they don't use LiPo anymore. But still for helicopters, they're lighter than usual. So, brushless motors. I'm not going to show you the theory about the brushes and brushless motors. Maybe you know even more than me. But in brushed motors, you have just two wires, but there is like brushes between the moving part and non-moving part, so there's sparks and they're not very effective. So they start making these brushless motors, like computer fans and the real one for quadcopters and this one. They have three wires and they have a sensor inside usually to tell you where exactly is your rotor, so you can switch the next from these magnetic fields. So it means they're complicated. You need something to manage all of this thing when the next magnetic field to be, like electromagnetic field to be switched on. So to do this, you need something like these guys. These guys. Maybe you know this. It's like electronic speed controller. So these three wires, they're connecting to the motor. And this one you have to the batteries. And from here, you have some signal, so it will tell these guys, okay, spin like on how many RPMs, or spin faster, or stop. You manage this from these guys. So, next part, the brain. The brain, see, I have brains here. So, this one is when I started with this stuff. So this is the flight controller, or like, yes, and most exciting for me one, well, they're based on the 80 mega chips, which means the same like Arduino. Means you can program them with the same Arduino tools that you have in home, your Arduino ID, everything. You can use them for this.
You don't have that.
In regular home.
They're almost like this one. So, small Arduino, they started with this one in general. But how to see, somebody tried to make money, like this guy, creating custom electronics. So they combine these two to this guy. So they're creating these flight controllers. And there's a lot of writing. Chinese or something, with China in English. So bad.
Chinglish.
Yes. So worse translation. But usually, you ask how many axes it have. If it only have gyros, means it can only track how many degrees it is. It three axes. If it also have accelerometers, you can track how we are moving. It's six axes. And recently they start talking about the 10 degrees of freedom, which means like gyro, accelerometers, you have compass, so you can understand where is north, so you can have a return to home possibility. You go somewhere, and this guy have a GPS, you know where it is, and he can go home to the initial place. You need for this magnetometer, trackways, compass, you need compass. And the 10 degrees is barometer, so you can track how you are, what is your height? So you can auto level. So you can just switch one switch and go to have a coffee or pee pee or something. So it will just stay there. For this one, you need the barometric barometer. And one example, for example, is this guy. It's like, I don't know, like $7. It's not so expensive. And you have all of the 10 degrees. All of this is on this board. So one more interesting thing is hot seat. In order to power this, you need 5 volts, usually. So you can have a different battery, but you already have battery. So why to not use it? So it have one additional, this cable. It's used not only for the signals, but also to provide the electricity to this guy. It's named like battery elimination circuit. You don't have additional battery. You just use from here have like 7 volt or 11 volt or something, but here's the stable 5 volts. So if you don't know what to use this for, you can use it like a little cheap DC to DC converter. Just put batteries here, a lot of them, and 5 volts here. So yes, you don't need to put exactly the motor. You just can use this part for something. And very, very important thing. Multi-V. So the cool stuff about this thing is that you can put your custom software on it, and it's open source. It's named Multi-V. VCAM before there was not this guy, so people just broke the V Lunjack stick, and it had this gyros inside. So it started from there, and they created the Arduino software. So this is completely open source. You can download it. Maybe I will show it now. So let's try the dangerous stuff. So we connect your LiPo to the speed controller. See, LiPo is here. So usually here we have a motor, but we don't spin here motors. It's too dangerous. So you have 5 volts here going to the flight controller. Let's connect this guy. Where was like G3 maybe?
Next time, okay.
So it's working. And after this, you need maybe something else. You need this FTDI guy, something that will connect here to your computer. So let's just be sure. So we connect this guy here. Oops, not here. And we have this. Let's see if it will work. Multi-V. So, which one is this? So now, it will see how this guy is going, and it's not going anywhere. So, just a second. I will show it after this. No, now we will lose time. So you can see here, like what configuration this guy is running, and when I move it, it moves also there. But let's try after this to continue now with the better stuff. So MoonTV is in general extremely good open source flat brain like surgery. You put this in your controller, you can configure it with usual Arduino and change it, make you what you want. So next time you need to manage this guy from somewhere, so you need something like receiver, this one is receiver, and transmitter. So you have this in your hands, and this guy is going with the fly things. It's connected to your brain, so you send commands from here to the guy, and he is commanding the brain. So they usually come in pairs. So every company have like pair, transmitter and receiver. There are several main guys which are like famous, like Futaba, if you know something. So they're becoming legends. So what is important from one radio, it's working on different frequencies, but this one is what I'm using. It's internationally allowed, and it's especially for radio-controlled stuff. It's pretty good, you can go on the kilometer, in fact. And also the important is what is the protocol between your transmitter and your receiver. There's a different thing like Spectrum company, they're using DCM or something. I think the Japanese protocols are derivatives on this one. They have DSMJ or something. And Devo is very famous one, it's by Valkyra. They have very good transmitters, but expensive. And this FlySky, I will tell you why it's cool. I'm using this one now. It's not so good, but they have something more than how good is it. And channels, you need, how to see, for all of this, a movement, you need different channels, like going up and down is one channel, my front and back is second, and going here is third. If you want more, like moving your camera will become the next channel, so small as possible. And four for the quadcopters, at least four.
These are not multiplexed.
It can be in how to see in one channel, but after they reach the brain, they again need to be split on four, so they have like a PPM SIM or something, which is you send them in one signal encoded or something, but you still need to divide them after some point. So yes, you need at least four. And these guys, they have for different modes. So your throttle means you're going up and down, can be on this guy or on this guy. And the worldwide, like US and everywhere, usually the throttle is here. Throttle is here. And this is the mode 2. In Japan only, it's mode 1. It's here. So you need for yourself to decide where you will survive. You buy everything in Japan. So go first with mode 1. Or you will move somewhere, so better go with mode 2. And also you can have... these are important words, RTF or BNF. RTF means these guys are bound together. You can use it, but I cannot power with this thing, this cool guy that I will show you after this. Because, let's see, they are not bound together. So this one is ready to fly. So this one is ready to fly. I don't need to do anything, but... But they appear, fufu. Yes. And by the flies, you can just buy these guys, different of these guys, and you can bound them to some magic universal remote which can manage all of them. The one ring to lead them all. You know, the guy. And this is the guy. No, there's a lot of them. And all of them have a different... advantages, like Devo are very good, Futaba is great, but they cost a lot of money. And this Turnigy guy, it costs $50. It's a $50 thing. But one good thing is it have this thing that you can stick additional modules, so you can have different protocols. This FlySky or Devo. You just need to buy this different modules and just stick them here. Another thing that is extremely cool, see here, open source firmware, which means these guys are again with 80 mega chip inside, and you can program them with Arduino. How cool is it? So the name of the project is this one. So it will turn your $50 magic control to $500 because it will have all the features let the expensive guys, but open sourced. So remember the guy. This one is, you just buy the guy, bring it home, unpack it, and install this guy immediately. And you have 10 times improvement. So, yes. So, we know that. What was the English, like, the pride of the boys is the size of their toys. So, we have it. We want it big, but how to see, starting big is sometimes difficult. So start small. Like I know he flies like huge one. I cannot afford this. I cannot fly it home. So I started with small one that I can buy for this guy, for example. It costs Nissan Q100. Even not, so I can throw it. No, I'm not so happy, but I mean, you see, this is small but beautiful. See, it's Hubsan. It's named Hubsan. You can buy this now in Japan from about a month or something. It costs like Gosenen, this one, and nobody don't buy it because they're mode 2. Means somebody just import them as I know from this company, and they just paint the body in different colors and helps to sell them with different name, but it's mode 2, so nobody don't buy them, because in Japan it's mode 1. So yes, Gosenen, you can have this one, but I don't...
What's mode 2 and mode 1?
I told you before, where is your throttle? Where is, how to see? So if you want to go up and down, on mode 2 it's here. So if you one time start like this one, in Japan it's here.
Yeah.
So, okay. How to see, everybody's starting in something and continue with this one. So, but this one is very fragile. It's like a jewelry, but usually happens like this one. It happens to me, and I need to open it, replace it. So I'm not advising starting with this one. Better start with something. I will show you now the gallery of my toys. They're small but beautiful. So this one, it's hard to see. The first time when they lied to me, because it's my first quad that I bought, and it's a rebranded one. Somebody just paint this black and sell it to me like 2 times more expensive than it's in real. But I was not very pissed off because it's still fine. You can feel the pain, how many times I crush it. It's hot to see, it's great. So I'm not complaining very much. And this is my everyday flyer, this guy. It was like this one, very toyish look. Ladybird, but I removed half of the plastic and you can still feel the pain. See, there's some tapes, things, so it's crushing like 20 times per day. And these guys here just for the size. And now I'm building the real one now. It's already with KK board and K brushless motors, so it's a little real. I already crushed also this one. It's here. It's very light frame, so I ordered now from Turkish guys some carbon fiber thing that we tried first before
making it great.
Yes. So, yes, it's hotsy. I'm still working on this one. And some useful links. Banggood is the site for the... You can buy helicopters. Everybody buying from this one. It's Chinese size. But they have free worldwide shipping. So if you want to buy something, go to Banggood. I know the name is, you know, the toys, yes? But see, everybody buying from this one. Worldwide people buying helicopters from this site. Cheap and worldwide free shipping.
Because in Banggood.
Yes, but it's taking time. It's like 3 weeks or something. And AliExpress is the same. Alibaba Group, they're selling everything. And this Hobby King is the hobby. It's already the important stuff. It's in Hong Kong, I think. And everything about the flying and everything about hobbies, they sell everything. So this is the real stuff is there. And this RS Groups it's the discussion forum. There's so many knowledge there, it will take you, I don't know, months maybe, just to go through the list. So when you decide, if you decide to do something, this is the place where you ask for information, but stupid
this
questions.
This is Hacker News for quadcopters.
Yes, it's Hacker News. quad News, Quad Hackers, something. It's great site. So just to give you some kickstart, you can go to Amazon and buy this guy. See, it's very cheap, it's very affordable. So I tell you before about this Fly Sky protocol. The good thing is some of the small guys, you can manage them with this huge. So you need just one of the universal controls. You can just after this buy only helicopters, because usually all of these guys comes with their own transmitter. So after two or three, you already don't know what to do with all transmitters in home. But if it's Fly Sky compatible, you can just buy this cheap guy, upgrade it with open source, and just buy helicopters. And this one is Sima. It's most used one, maybe. It's tough, it's cheap, there's a lot of... So it's platform.
Is this the Japanese Amazon or...?
No, the original Amazon.com. So an other one, this Banggood top 10. This, you can see V9 something 9. This is also the very good line. It's by Valkyra Toys. This is the guy that was the ladybug things. But the recent one, they have some fancy stuff, like a water cannon. So you can just go like here. And there's like a channel just to go to Paco and here. So yes, so you can see the prices is not so bad. I maybe would prefer this one. This is the thing that I have. And see, there's a lot of propellers, batteries. Very good kit. So if you want to start, go CNN, wait 3 weeks, you have it. And for the real otaki, this is the crazy file. It will become, it's still Hubsy, some not Kickstarter, but it's still in pre-orders state. It's not ready, but it's a kit. So they give you all these parts and manuals and everything in open source hardware, open source, open hardware. You just can create this guy. You have radio, everything, the software is open source, everything. It costs like, it's not very clear, but it's 149. So, yes, if you want really to be inside this, it's small, it's like this one. So you can fly it here. And I think it's very, very long presentation. Huh? So it's over. I can maybe just show you the last one. I made this one yesterday. Mm-hmm. it's flying in general. Yes, you can see. I need to bind it to my transmitter guy. Okay, so we. But it's not very good fire. I just wanted to illustrate it. So, but Hopsy, it's very. It's almost like missing in. Because it's just parts and balsa tree. It's cheap board.
It's like a mosquito.
Wow! Okay. So, and this one is the cool one. I told you it's like slightly different. It's like jewelry. It's extremely agile.
And expensive.
It's Gosen. So. But Hubsy is very fragile, but it's a real one. This one, I just make it for you. And this one is, you can buy it. So you will see the movement, see?
Oh.
It's slightly different animal, huh?
It's
see,
a
whale. So this is the stuff. But Hubsy, if I crush it one time, most of the times it's over. So, it's not a really good thing to start with. Yeah,
your wife doesn't run up to them with your
phone. It does not have a camera, but...
Oh.
So, yes, this is the guy. I will try now to... Oh.
Can you carry stuff with it? Can you carry stuff with it?
I'm trying now to carry it with this stuff. Uh-huh. If if you, this is the camera. See, the camera, spy camera. So they have presently this in key something something. So let's see, it's it have its own battery. You just stick it here on the bottom, and you can fly it like this one.
Over Rotenburg in Japan.
But you can possibly. But let's see, it cannot, it does not have transmitter for the video, so I need just to take the video and after this.
And then you're like,
so send it to the forum and after this, make it home. So, yes, this is the home.
Can you fly it under, under consumption of alcohol? Can you still
fly properly? I crush it, baby.
Okay.
Yes. Thank you very much.